हेलो फ्रेंड, टुडे वी आर डिस्कस द जेंगो AWS S3 बकेट, द अमेजॉन S3 बकेट, हाउ टू यूज इन जेंगो वी आर डिस्कसिंग टुडे। हियर फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू टू वॉचिंग माई वीडियो एंड प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड लाइक माई वीडियो। द जेंगो ऑल इमेजेस शुड बी स्टोर इन मीडिया फोल्डर, दैट्स वाई द मीडिया साइज शुड बी इंक्रीजेस। समटाइम द मीडिया साइज should be increases and that's why project should be affected to the storage. Here we are discuss all media images should be uploaded in AWS S3 bucket. How it is possible? That's why we are discussing here today. First, we create the AWS S3 bucket login, and in that we create a bucket and we create one user. That user provided the security key and access right, that key should be integrated to the Django. Here this is a Amazon portal here. Okay, you can log in. First if you have a new user, then you can create a new account. Okay, in that you can fill up the your personal information. In that we he provide the debit card number. In that he deduct the 2 rupees only. Okay, this is a first premium. The 1 year he freely provided. After that, he can pay the every bucket as per the bucket size. Now we already have registered it. Okay, then we create we log in the Amazon, click on the root user. Okay, and enter your email ID and enter your password and sign in. Okay. Now we create a user, and after that we create a bucket. Okay, go to the services. Here click on IAMs in the security identity. In that IAM is here. Click on the IAM. Okay, then in left hand side here the user here, right? You click on the user and add user. Now user, my name is Sanket. I create my name user. Okay, and here the access type, there are two types of access, right? It's programmatically access or it is AWS management console access. We are check on the programmatically access because we integrate the AWS to the Django. Okay, that's why we have access to the access key ID and security key ID. Otherwise you can also use to the console access, but that way only you have password required, and that's why we have check on the programmatically access. Okay, then here we access the permission, the Django S3 storage. In that we have Amazon S3 full access we have provided. We select that Django S3 storage. Inside we can provide a read, write and delete all access we can access. That's why we have select on Django S3 storage. The next here the add tag, it is optional. You can add to the tag here. This is you can use as a organize and track and control access to this user also. Okay, now this is a review. You can check the username as a Sanket, and this is a AWS access type as a programmatically access here, and the permission is not set. Okay, now permission is fully accessed. It is Django S3 storage. Now we click on create user. Okay, now here the user has created. This is a downloaded CV. You can download the CV inside. In the CV you can access the access key ID and security. This is very important things. You can download the CV, okay, in your disk. Okay, this is because this credential not visible after that when you close it, right? Then the access key ID, this access key ID we can use in the Django configuration file. Okay, now here this is a Django setting.py file. Here we have create a configuration. Okay, the AWS access key we are required, and the secret access key we are required, and storage bucket name we are required. The all these three value we are storing in the config.py file. Now we have pasting access key ID here. Okay, and the secret key you can show this is a hidden, okay, you can copy, you cannot share it that secret key ID, otherwise your S3 bucket should be hacked. Okay, now the storage bucket name, we have only create a username. Now we create a bucket, then you go to the services, and here this is a storage inside the S3, right? Now we click on S3. Okay, here this is a list of bucket we already created. Now we are newly created bucket. The create, click on the create bucket, and the bucket name should be Sanket-media. Okay, now my bucket name is Sanket-media, and you can region, we have selected Mumbai. You can your region also, if you are US, anything, you can select that particular region. Okay, and here the checkbox of the block all the public access, because we have publicly access that my bucket. Okay, and this is acknowledgement, is this is a checkbox on, this is acknowledgement for publicly we accesses. Now click on the create bucket. Now bucket will be created. The bucket name is, my bucket name is Sanket-media, that we can be added in here, Sanket-media. Okay, here this is my configuration file. That file will not show in to the every user, that's why we configure that's way. This is a access key, this is a security access key, and this is a storage name, and this is a S3 domain name, this is my domain name, S3 amazon.com. after that images will be showing in the path. Okay, this is a file cache control size. Okay, and only we have store, only we have stored in the media folder. Here this is a structure here, this is my this is my app, this is a project, and this is a media and static. Now we only store the media folder, okay, not storing the static. You can also store static folder also here, okay, but currently we have only stored the media folder. That's why the media file location is media, and default file storage location is media storage. Here we create a one the file, it is a storage backend.py. inside we have django.config.setting, and this is the S3 bucket storage and media S3 bucket. Inside we have location, we can refer to the setting.py file. Here you can check the location as a media. Okay, and this is a file overlap is false. Okay, because the file, same file should be accessed in a different way. Okay, that's why we have overlapping is false. Okay, now we have installed the two packages. The one is pip install the boot 3. Okay, we have already installed it. Okay, and second package is pip install django-storage. Okay, there are two packages we will install. Okay, after that in setting.py you can add the setting installation app inside the storage. Okay, this is important thing, you can add the storage app here. Okay, now all the configuration we are done. Okay, we go to the dashboard. Okay, here we have created the dashboard. Okay, we create one table as an employee table. Inside we have photos is here. Now photo is hidden because this photo are referred to the S3 bucket. Now in my S3 bucket is empty. Okay, here you can check the S3 bucket is empty. Okay, now we upload the image. If we click on the any form, upload the any image, we select the image, suppose we select t-shirt.this. okay, and submitted. Okay, now file should be upload. Okay, you can check it, you can right click on that image, inspect element, and here we can check the path, image path, http sanket-media s3 amazon.com, means the image should be stored in S3 bucket. You can check the S3 bucket, you can refresh the page. Okay, here media, inside document, then file should be uploaded. Okay, this is a way you can upload the file to the S3 bucket. That means the your file, now you can check the media folder, you can go to the media. Okay, now media in document, inside the t-shirt.jpg is not there, means my file is moved only S3 bucket, not stored in the media folder. okay, this is my older file here, that's why file is there. But normally media folder is not required, okay, in the current situation. Okay, all the files should be uploaded in S3 bucket. Okay, this is a way you can access all media to the S3 bucket. That's why the file folder size should be fixed. Okay, only the media folder move to the S3 bucket. Okay, if you have any doubt regarding the S3 bucket, please comment it and also follow my Git. Okay, also all the code in the Git repository is also here. Okay, thank you watching my video. Please subscribe my channel and like my video. Thank you guys.